In this segment, we'll learn how to connect a SolarSync sensor to the X-Core controller. The X-Core is compatible with the regular hardwired SolarSync as well as the wireless version of SolarSync. The SolarSync sensor detects the weather patterns and automatically adjusts the controller's season adjust, which in turn adjusts the run times so that it moves them up and down based on the current weather. So here we'll be talking about actually hooking up the SolarSync to the X-Core controller. And I want to mention two things up front. Number one is when you turn the dial to SolarSync settings, when there's no sensor hooked up yet, you're going to get a series of dashed lines and possibly an error message. And all that's telling you is the X-Core says, hey, listen, I don't have a sensor hooked up to me yet, so I'm not going to give you the programming options that I will once the sensor is hooked up. So don't be afraid if you see some dashed lines there. The second is sensor placement, and this part's really important. You really need to verify that you've got your sensor out in as many hours of sunlight all day long as possible. SolarSync works very heavily off of the solar radiation readings, and if it's cloudy or if it's sunny, and if your house is blocking that sensor for half the day, it's not going to get correct readings. Secondly, the hardwired SolarSync, the wire can be extended up to 200 feet. It comes with 40 feet of wire from the factory, but feel free to go up to 200 feet using the same type and gauge of wire that's already attached to the sensor. So let's go ahead and start by removing the lower cover of the X-Core. And here to the left, you'll notice that we've got the two sensor terminals. And the first step that we're going to do is basically turn off the power, and you'll see these X-Core go to a blank screen. The sensor has a black and green wire, whether it's a wireless receiver or it's the actual sensor hardwired up to the roof. The black and green wires go in the two sensor terminals. It does not matter which is the green or which is the black as to which goes to what sensor terminal. So the X-Core is also compatible with the wireless version of the SolarSync, and the wireless version comes with two pieces. The first is a receiver, and this wires directly to the controller, and the other portion of the unit is the wireless sensor. They come from the factory already on the same frequency and talking, but it's always a good idea to initialize communication once you've installed the two units. So now turn on the power to the controller, and once you do, the receiver's light will turn red, meaning he's in search mode. You'll want to take the spindle button on the actual sensor and hold it down and release it, and it will send out a signal to the receiver. Once the receiver receives that signal, he'll start flashing a few times, meaning that he's acknowledged the sensor, and then the light on the receiver will go out. This only applies to wireless SolarSync. Now that the sensor is hooked up to the X-Core, we can take the dial and turn it to the SolarSync settings position. You'll notice you no longer have dashed lines, but you have two numbers that you can adjust. The first number is the region, and that will show where it is that you live, either coastal, mountain, desert, you know, what your average temperatures are. The second number here is the 1 through 10 water adjustment. 10 meaning more water, 1 meaning less water. It comes preset from the factory at 5, and that's a good starting point for you to be able to move up and down after you've got it installed for adjustments. So as far as determining your region goes, we've included a handy chart in the owner's manual, and the first section of the chart to determine your region is based on your average ET in the hot months. That's really the most effective and correct method with which to choose. But the second method we give you is there's a series of average high temperatures for the hottest months that you can select. And the third method is basically a region description, whether you're coastal, mountain, inland, or desert. So you've got four regions to choose from. Regions 1, 2, 3, or 4. 1 is the cooler areas, and 4 is the hottest areas. The other setting that you'll set for the SolarSync is the water adjustment. This setting is a 1 to 10 scale that allows for easy adjustment to fine-tune your watering program. Upon installation of the sensor, it is recommended that this setting stays at the default value of 5, which is right in the middle. Then if you notice down the road that the seasonal adjust value is lower or higher than expected, you can modify the water adjustment to fine-tune it. So now that we've had the sensor installed for a week or two, you'll want to go back and review the property and see if areas are too wet or too dry. You'll notice, first of all, when you go to season adjustment, you want to see what percentage your controller is being ran at. And it'll change every night at midnight to a new percentage, whether or not it's a water day that next day. But you know what you set it at originally, at 100% season adjustment, what your run times were. And depending on what that percentage is in the controller a week or two later when you're checking this, you'll know if you're running too wet or too dry. If the percentage is running really low and you think that it shouldn't be that low, you've probably chosen the wrong region to begin with. So in this case, what will happen is you'll see a low percentage number in the season adjust, and you've chosen the wrong region. So if you were to lower the region number down, it will increase the season adjust percentage. So if you're looking for more percentage numbers, lower your region down by one click. Of course, the first part to be able to adjust is the 1 through 10, and if that has not worked out for you, then you need to go as far as changing the region. So if you notice that your season adjust is running real low, too low of a number that you think it should be, you've originally chosen region 3, you can reduce that down to region 2, and that'll make your percentage ride higher on a regular basis, or give you more water. Now remember, the Solar Sync only changes the station run times. The start times and the days to water remain the same throughout all the adjustments. So if the entire system is a little bit too dry, you can always add one more day during the week, or two more days of water during the week, and that will water everybody that one more day. Same thing, if it's too wet, you can take away one day, and that may make the difference you're looking for. The other way in which you can change, if it's just a single station that's too wet or too dry, but everything else looks pretty good, you can simply go to that individual station, and whatever he's running at currently, you can raise him up or down individually. So now, when the controller adjusts his percentage up and down, that station has a new starting point with which to go from. So if that one zone's too wet, take off 3 or 4 minutes. And he'll move up and down with everybody else's new percentage. Or if it's too dry as well, you can add a few minutes, 2, 3, 4, or 5 minutes. And then he'll move up and down with everybody else. Adjusting a solar sink for weather changes will take some trial and error to fine-tune it. But be patient, and you will be rewarded with a water-efficient system that applies water to the plant material when it needs it and in the correct amount.